this, man. He's gonna kill it.
Marvelous Beats. Real, for real, I wasn't even gonna make a video about this, but it got kind of interesting, so I said, whatever, let's do it. Okay, so in this video here, it appears that we have like a family here and a child that's playing violin. They seem to be on the corner of a parking lot in some department store, and yeah, the child is playing violin. So usually with hip-hop violinist videos across social media and stuff, my fans, they tag me in it dozens of times. I appreciate that y'all see those videos and y'all think of me. That means a lot. Appreciate that. So I finally look at this video and I'm watching it. And, you know, as I'm watching it, I'm thinking to myself, like, you know, this sounds very, very, very familiar. So I start going through the comments, and of course, I see people in the comments that have already figured it out. So this kid was lip syncing or violin syncing to a very popular violin cover of 50 Cent in the Club by violinist Josh Vietti. I apologize if I'm pronouncing that wrong. Josh Vietti, I think. Full stop. Okay, there's two ways to look at this situation. First way to look at this is that they are tweaking. And A, because the person who really did this violin cover and this video that's not going viral and is now being looked at as a fraud is not doing any good for street performers as a whole. Going through the comments, you can already see people kind of have and not kind of feel validated that street performers are faking it, or most of them are faking it, or just, you know, to pull in a con. B, the artist, again, who really did this cover, and this post is going viral across all these major, you know, IG pages and stuff, he's not getting the credit at all. So the other way to look at this situation is basically, you know, everybody, including this kid and his family, are in a global pandemic and just doing what they gotta do to survive, you know, get by, do what they gotta do to get to the bag. And then, of course, B, is that the artist now, that everybody's finding out, and you know, getting the tags right and stuff, now he's getting the credit, you know, so it's kind of like a win-win. So for me, as a violinist that was on the street for about 4 straight years and, you know, made it to the stage from the street, I made a career out of, you know, service in the community, I'm definitely leaning more towards the first way of looking at this, as far as like the kind of tweaking, because look at it now you got a problem. Either you're gonna have to change the hustle, or you're gonna have to go to a new location, because now everybody knows, you know. Funny enough, if the kid was actually out there with his family, with the violin, just, you know, busting out a little, you know, Twinkle Little Star, Mary Had a Lamb, a light minuet in G, like, people would still tip them, you know what I'm saying? Because people are not always just the talent. People are tipping because they appreciate the bravery. They appreciate the passion. They appreciate, or they understand, the need and essentially the desperation. And they will tip you just because of that. You don't need to, you know, go out there and fake, you know, play an instrument. You know, it's you don't have to do all that. But hey, what I know, you know what I'm saying? Do what you gotta do. You're your own person. That's cool. I am nobody to judge. What was really interesting to me was the community of hip-hop violinists that responded, and some that didn't respond at all. I don't know if they just haven't seen it yet, or, you know, they didn't have time for it. But, you know, shout out to violinists like Demola, Shout out to Lee Anglin, shout out to Dominique. I saw all of them kind of come together and, you know, let these outlets know, like, yo, this is Josh's song, you know, so, and, you know, they came together in that comment section. I was really, really happy to see that. On the contrary, one response from, like, one of the OGs of this hip-hop violinist thing, Damien Escobar, he got in the comment section, responded, and he was kind of leaning more to the second perspective I described, where it's like, you know, let the kid and their family get to their bag, man, you know what I'm saying? And he said, quote, you know, this wouldn't be the first time somebody's music is being used or stolen. From what I've seen and experienced in, like, the space of, like, hip-hop violinists, there's probably only, like, really two events where I've seen everybody kind of come together like that. One was the police brutality murder of that kid, Elijah, who was also a violinist. And I saw a bunch of hip hop artists come together and kind of do like a rally, kind of like a protest. That was like super dope. And then when Shade Room, I think on like National Violinist Day, had decided to highlight, I think like 8 to 9 violinists in that post. And then, you know, all the hip-hop violinists got in on that post and just, like, you know, just having some conversation there. It was pretty cool. But I think that, you know, at this space of hip-hop violinists, we are very much embedded in the culture, in our culture. So it's like, I think that everybody should really get to know us more, and, like, we should all just come together more and do things like that, because we have a lot of positive vibes to offer to the world, you know what I mean? So, you know, go check out all those violinists I named. Go ahead and like this video, subscribe, drop a comment. You know, it's all free. You know, it helps us out, man. All right, this is Marvelous Beast, so I'm signing out. Peace.